Laurel Highlands have been calling my name for quite a while. 4 days, 3 nights, 70 miles. This is one of those trails that you can just zone out, enjoy the scenery, take everything in, take all the sights in, and just forget all your troubles. Hey guys, and welcome to Outdoor Adventures. I'm Frozen, and thanks for joining me. Well guys, Laurel Highlands have been calling my name for quite a while, and I have decided to return. Starting at mile marker 0 this time, and we're gonna walk to Johnstown and end up at mile marker 70. It'll be 4 days, 3 nights, doing 70 miles. Let's get started. And it just got real again. Mile marker 0. And I think this is actually brand new. I don't remember seeing this last time, and it looks pretty new. So let's walk up here and let's begin our adventure. Okay, so here is a map of the Laurel Highlands. We are pretty much right here where that P is, an Ohio pile. Today we're going to hike about 18.2 miles to Route 653. The next day we're going to hike about 20 miles and we're going to see Seven Springs. And we're going to stay in Forbes State Forest near the Turnpike, so right here. The following day, which will be Wednesday, we're going to check out Beam Rocks briefly. And then we're going to walk another 21 miles all the way down to Route 271 shelter area. From there, we have a quick day and we'll hike 14 miles out to Johnstown in the parking lot, and I'll have a ride waiting there for me. So I really, really wanted to do this trail again, especially now that my base weight has come down so much. I am at 11 pounds base weight, 11.2, and the last time I did this, my base weight was 25.7 pounds. So that's a big change. Our first set of rocks, first set of glacial rocks. Pretty cool. Now we'll be seeing stuff like this for the next 69 miles, just past mile marker 1. So we'll also be seeing terrain like this. It's just very, very rocky. This is actually the first time I'm on this trail in something other than boots. Got my La Sportiva Wildcats on again. They have several shelters set up along the trail. They're very nice shelter areas too. Most of the shelters even have chopped wood for you to use, but you have to reserve your shelters in advance to keep it legal. So down there is the active set of train tracks, and to the right of the train tracks is the Youghiogheny River, which once we climb up to the top of this hill, we'll be able to see in pretty great detail. Woo! Feels really good to be back here. It's gonna be such an amazing trip. I can already feel it right now. We want to take a look at the elevation profile. This is what we're gonna do each day. We started around 1300 feet and we'll get up to probably around 3000 feet today. So not too much, but this is gonna be the worst day as far as elevation goes. And then you can see it's semi-flat the rest of the trip until you get down to day 4 where you start going downhill.
Miles to go.
Some steps to walk down.
Coming to our first little water crossing right here. Laurel Highlands, they have bridges mostly going over any kind of stream crossing, so it's really nice what they do and how well maintained this trail is.
This is one of those trails that you can just zone out, enjoy the scenery, take everything in, take all the sights in, and just forget all your troubles. They'll all just disappear. And it's an amazing feeling being on this trail for a couple days too. Because you feel like you're actually going somewhere. Like with the loop, you know you're gonna eventually end up in the same spot. With a hike like this, a through hike like this, you know, you end up somewhere different.
Starting to get out of the tree cover here. You can see how far we came up so far, maybe a little bit here.
But it's about 10 o'clock and we should be around mile marker 5. I think it's coming up soon here. So, making good time.
Climbed up a little hill and we are at the Ohio Pile shelters. I don't know if you guys can see them down there or not. Yeah, you guys won't be able to see them, but if we wanted to camp, that's where we would go. Follow the blue blaze and that'll take you down to the shelter area. For us, going north to Johnstown. Going up a decent bit of elevation.
All right, well, I think I'm about halfway up this hill. A lot of elevation gain in a short amount of time. Plus the full pack isn't helping, but. I had to stop for a quick break, catch my breath a little bit here.
So here is the ground level. So you can see it's kind of just straight up almost. Oh, look at that. Oh, marker 7.
That hill wasn't really half bad, to be honest. I thought I took a break about halfway up. I was almost at the top. Hey, I'll take it. I guess it's harder going down because of knee issues for me than it is coming up. So that's, wow, it's great news. So we just have a little more uphill to go here and then we'll be on top of the ridge.
Okay. You can see where we came down, or we came up from over there, from the bottom of that hill. So that's really cool. Really nice, a lot of elevation. But this is really nice to look at in the fall when all this stuff is gone. You can see straight out over, get a nice, nice view. Some nice seats. Don't mind if I do.
It's about 12:20. We're almost at mile marker 10. Sun's still out. No storms, no nothing. So this is good. So feet are doing great and I'm ready to keep moving.
This is what I'm talking about. This is just so cool to see this stuff in the middle of the woods. Like a solid rock wall.
Alrighty. Well, I think this is a good spot to stop for lunch. It's about 12:30 right now. So I'm looking to get to camp around 5 or something, maybe 6. Still got a clear sky, so I'm happy about that. So I brought my new alcohol stove on this trip too. I figured, why not see how it does on a longer trip here. But this is just your standard cat food can, plus a little tomato paste can, and wrap it in carbon felt. And it actually works very, very well. All right, we'll let that go.
Ramen noodle.
So I'm gonna take my shoes off and let my feet air out. And this should prevent any blisters that I may get today. And then as soon as I'm done with this, we'll get back on the trail and finish up the last 8 miles of this thing. We should be coming up on a lake at some point today. I'm debating whether I want to take a dip. I don't know how deep it is, but I think taking a swim would really feel good, really cool me down, especially on a humid day like today. I think it would be awesome.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Man, there's fish in here too. Look at that. Look at that fish. I don't know if I can see the fish. Wow, that's pretty cool. Some big fish in there too.
Yeah, I decided to go for a dip. I can't pass this up, man. It's too good. Oh. Oh, man. Fantastic. Ooh. All right. Okay. Well, I'm gonna come back ashore, dry off a little bit, and then we'll keep going. Awesome though. This is really cool.
It's getting hot, it was pretty humid, and I'm cooled right down. That was awesome. We have arrived at Route 653 shelter area. I found a beautiful spot right here next to these two shelters. Got a fire ring and a picnic table. Woods right there, restrooms are right there, water pumps right there. New hammock. It's not anything crazy. It's the same old war bonnet blackbird that you're used to, except it's a single layer now instead of a double. And then if you notice, I have a different tarp for people that are used to the channel. This is a Cuban fiber hammock gear hex tarp with the doors. You see we have the doors pulled back right now. I have a whole video on the door management system, which you can watch right over here. But my thought was, yes, I already had a tarp, and yes, I already had a hammock. But my thoughts are, you know, I'm going lighter and lighter, and there's only so many things you can get to make yourself lighter. Plus, I don't ever want to sleep in a tent again, and now that I have an extra tarp and an extra hammock, me and my girlfriend can actually go hammock camping and do it comfortably. So, I will continue to lighten my gear up, and now we have two hammocks that we can use. So hopefully she can sleep in a hammock, because I'm never doing a tent. Never doing a tent. Ever again. So I just checked the weather, like 5 minutes ago. And the weathermen have been kind of saying this storm is going to happen tonight on and off. It was at 0% yesterday, then it was at 80, then it was 20, and then it was 40 this morning. Now it's back up to 80. And they said it's going to rain all day tomorrow and all day Thursday. So, that's not good. I'm hoping that changes. I mean, I don't mind walking in the rain, whatever. 20 miles in the rain is gonna not be as good as 20 miles in partly cloudy skies at 70 degrees, but, you know, I'll deal with it. However, I really want to use the camera that I'm using instead of the waterproof camera, because this one has better video and better audio. And that was one of my reasons for coming out here, was to get a better video of the Laurel Highlands and to kind of challenge myself to do it in 4 days compared to six.
So we'll see how it goes tomorrow. It's supposed to start storming tonight around 10 o'clock. We'll see. I don't know. We have blue skies right now and really no dark clouds or anything, but you know that can change in a heartbeat. But at least we got camp set up. So I'm gonna bring all my other stuff down here. Also, I wanted to show you this. This is, I don't know how good you can see it, but this is a Dutchware spider. Okay, right here. And what you do is you basically use this in place of a marlin spike hitch. So I right now have a whoopee sling on my hammock. But what you do is you take the whoopee sling, you put it underneath of the spider, and then you drop the two lines down through the top of these little this little bracket right here. And what that does, it basically locks it into place. It allows you to move this spider up and down on the webbing. So in case you have some really, really close trees, you could, you know, crank it back all the way to the tree if you wanted to. That way you're not left with, you know, a ridiculous saggy hang. So I had to repackage all of my Mountain House meals that I'm bringing this trip because I just couldn't fit it in my bag. And I'm carrying a lot more food than I was last time as well. So what I did was I put them in a freezer Ziploc bag, quart size. Then I just cut the top off of one of the Mountain House meals and I'm just gonna cook in here. Crushed up Fritos, which tastes really good with this meal. So I'm looking forward to that. All right, we're gonna add these little Fritos. Oh, that's gonna be so good. Extra calories too, which is what I need for, you know, doing so many miles a day. Got some pretty loud thunder coming in, so I am going to move underneath the tarp. I'm glad I got all my dinner cooked and cleaned up and everything stored away. It was actually pretty good. Good timing, to be honest, but. All right, guys, well, it's about 9:15 or so, and the sun is just now going down. It keeps raining on and off, so I didn't even bother getting out. Nice and comfortable in here anyway, really. But we shall see what the weather will be like tomorrow morning. I'm going to stop checking my phone because it keeps changing. Right now it says 80% chance of rain, but I'm hoping not. Just because it would be a fun day if it wasn't raining tomorrow. But I'll take whatever I can get as long as I'm out here. That's all that matters. So guys, thanks for joining me today. Today was an awesome day. We covered a lot of hard mileage and should be a little easier tomorrow. I think we still have 19 or 20 miles, but there's not a lot of elevation gain, which is pretty good comparatively. So guys, good night. I will see you in the morning. Good morning, everybody. I think it's about 6 o'clock or so, but I slept pretty darn good last night, I must say. I used this cocoon silk liner as my summer bag because it was a little hot last night from my quilt, and well, I may as well get up, get some coffee and some breakfast. Lots of birds here, man. That's pretty cool. Well, I have gotten camp broken down, at least. It appears that it's going to be raining any second now, but so far it's playing nice, and I was able to get everything down and inside one of the shelters. These are one of the shelters at on the Laurel Highlands Trail. It's pretty nice. They got a chimney, three walls, you know, your standard lean-to shelter, and then usually people put dry wood underneath of the shelter floor. It's actually a really nice area. There's five shelters and five tent spots per area. And it's a really nice area. But I have got coffee. Well, water for coffee. I got my coffee kit right here. I have a bagel with some peanut butter to go. And I'm eating a strawberry Pop-Tart for breakfast this morning. So, pretty good breakfast for me. Last night was very, very peaceful. The wind was blowing on and off. Rain was coming in and out. But hey, no No complaints from me. I slept like a freaking baby. Oh, it was so refreshing this morning. I'm raring to go. I'm ready to do 20 miles today. I really am. But first, I need my coffee before I do anything here. So today we're going to be visiting Seven Springs, which is a ski resort here in Pennsylvania. The trail actually goes right through the slopes, so that's kind of neat. And then we will be crossing a bridge that goes over the turnpike and staying very close to that bridge today.
There's also this little graveyard, so here's Route 653 we just crossed. And then it puts you in this little graveyard right here. So these are very, very old graves. Some of them are, you can't even read the writing on it, but there's nothing on these. So rest in peace, everybody. And let's get back on the hiking trail here. It's a little hazy today, but you can see what I'm looking at right now. Great view, perfect. But the clouds aren't looking too good right now. The wind's starting to pick up. So, yeah, that's a shame. Oh well, it doesn't really matter actually. But man, that is a crazy view. I'm loving it. Pretty neat, must say. So we should be within maybe an hour of Seven Springs now. I think we have about 3 miles to go. Trail's been on and off as far as rocky and flat, good terrain. So, but can't complain today. I know tomorrow it's the roughest part of the trail, I believe, from what I remember at least. Lots of rocks, lots of roots, and you just gotta be careful. Ooh, tight squeeze. Well, it's about 10 o'clock right now. I'm making good time today as well. And I just passed my first couple hikers. I haven't seen anyone in about 23 miles. So we're definitely getting near Seven Springs. The Sporting Clays range ahead. So stay on the trail, don't get shot. Look at this stream. Pretty beautiful. I might stop and fill up some water here. I think I'm gonna do that. I don't know if you could hear that. I can hear the clay shooting range right over there. But yeah, I'm gonna stop and get some water here because I'm running low. At mile marker 26, they have this potable water source. So, right here. It just comes out right like that. So it is potable, you don't have to treat it. I've drank from here before on my last through hike of this place. So right at mile marker 26, they'll have this. And welcome to Seven Springs Mountain Resort.
Okay, we're about ready to hit the highest point of elevation on the Laurel Highlands Hiking Trail. Oh wow.
Absolutely beautiful. This is Lake Tahoe for anyone interested. They got the ski slopes, the lifts going still. It's kind of interesting. Maybe I can catch a ride down there. Really, really cool. Alright, let's figure out where to go here. Oh, I see it. A little sign up on one of the snowmakers. You literally scared the living crap out of me. Hey, horsey. Oh, there's two of you. Excellent. I just walk around the bend and I see a head standing there. It's pretty funny. Hey, horsey. Hey, bud. Hi. Well, I guess they don't like me. Oh, lots of horses. Hey there. Wow, you're big. Oh well, let's let them go. Getting hungry. And I just heard thunder. Is that a vulture? Sorry, I can't hold the camera steady. I'm zoomed in really, really far. But that almost looks like a vulture. I better not stop here for lunch. I was going to, but there's like four or five of these things. There's one over there, two over there, and then one just flew away. Really big birds. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong about that. I'd like to know what those are.
Okay, I just stopped for lunch, and I took off my shoes and socks. It's time to let them air out for 15 to 20 minutes, and then I'll get back on the trail after I eat. Right now I'm enjoying some delicious peach rings that I forgot I had, so I'm pretty excited about that. Oh, so good. Anyway, I'm gonna stuff my face because I'm really hungry and let my feet air out, and then we'll get back on the trail. Put some new socks on too.
I love these little pine tree forest areas. The ground is so comfortable to walk on because the pine needles cushion your feet. Yeah, there's a ton of roots, but you just avoid them. Plus, it's really scenic. You can actually see through the trees. Oh, this is so nice right here.
Well, guys, I can officially say that I am halfway done with this trail right now. Mile 35, awesome.
Well, we're at the 35 and a half mile marker. Oh, and it's not, the mailbox isn't doing too good, but I'm just reading over all the old entries. I'm trying to find mine, I can't remember where mine was. I know I was in the Bob Marley book, but who knows what happens to this stuff. I'm gonna try to close this. What can I do to fix this? There we go. Alright. It's better than it was, at least. Anyway, onward.
Oh, and it's nice and windy up here, too.
Looks like a snake has a salamander here. Well, I'm not going to interfere in that.
I'm actually more interested in walking the 1.3 miles to camp and getting off my feet.
It's about 4:40, so made good time again today.
And I mean, hell, 19 point something miles, that's pretty good. I found a pretty awesome spot right here. Trees are perfect distance apart today. Got an awesome fire pit right here. And there's someone staying at the shelter area with me. Anyway, skies are turning gray again, so I'm gonna get the tarp up, and then I'm gonna get some water, and we'll get ready for an awesome night. Nice picnic bench here. Getting kind of hungry, so I'm gonna cook up some dinner. Lasagna with meat sauce today. Absolutely delicious. So I was looking at the map. We actually did 20 miles today, and we have another 20 miles to go tomorrow. Oh my god, that is so good. So I put the underquilt on my hammock, but I'm leaving the ends open. It's supposed to be like 65 degrees tonight, so that's going to be a little too warm. My underquilt's rated for 30 degrees, but it should be all right, and I can vent it as necessary. I have all of my clothes airing out and drying from the humidity and the sweat today, so hopefully they'll be all good to go by tomorrow. I also like washed my socks and stuff too, so. Cotton ball soaked in petroleum jelly. Works out really well. Some basically Vaseline. What a great day. Saw some awesome sights. Seven Springs. Those rock formations that we walked through today too. I love being out here, man. It's nothing like it in the world, especially on such a long hike like this. You know, I encourage everyone to go on a hike where you're out here for 4 or 5 days. It doesn't even have to be high mileage. Just take some time away and have some time to yourself to think. Well, guys, I'm really looking forward to tomorrow. Hopefully I can have some time to let my feet heal now that everything's kind of settled down for the night. But I'm gonna watch a fire, listen to the audiobook, get the stars when they come out, and then when I get tired, go to bed, get in the hammock. And I'll see you tomorrow. Good night, guys.
Morning, everybody. It's 5:40 right now. It's a little early. The woodpeckers and the birds, they woke me up. I have a really good breakfast this morning, and I'm kind of excited to eat it, so that's going to be my motivation for getting out of this hammock right now, because I'm going to be honest, I'm pretty darn comfortable.
It's pre-cooked, pre-packaged bacon. Just gonna warm it up on the fire. Oh, and it's gonna be so damn good. Now we're gonna try this on a tortilla wrap. I think it's gonna be pretty good. Just based on the way this tastes, I think it's gonna be awesome.
That's what I thought it would taste like. That's really good.
So what do I have for coffee? I have this Taster's Choice instant coffee stuff, so that'll go in the water. And then I have this little packet of sugar, and I just add a little bit of Coffee Mate. Stir it up, and then you'll have nice, delicious morning coffee. Oh, wow, it's hot.
All right, let's hit it.
Well, today we're gonna walk about 20 miles to mile marker 57, or pretty darn close to it, really. And then it's from there, it's about a mile down to the shelter area. for Route 271. Now within the hour, I'll actually be at Beam Rocks, which is one of the coolest points on the trail. And it's just a pretty nice overlook. It's just right off the trail, it's not too far. So we're definitely gonna check that out. And with the weather like it is today and how early it is, we should have a beautiful overlook this morning.
So there's just a single red rose right in the middle of the trail. I didn't put it there, I don't know where it's from, but there's no roses anywhere around here. Just find that a little odd.
Interesting to say the least.
Top of Rocks, that's where we want to go. Up here.
I didn't get a lot of video up there because there was a group of, I think it was like five or six climbers getting ready to start their day. So I just missed my chance to be alone up there, but hey, it's all right, whatever. I've been up there alone for lunch and it's an amazing view. I'd say if you really want to see a good view of Beam Rocks Overlook, go in the fall because you'll have the colors changing on the leaves and it's a really, really, really nice view up there.
You can see for a long, long ways. It's pretty nice. So we'll be following this for a little while, so we'll have some nice scenery to the right of us.
So I just got recognized on the trail. He apparently watched the last video I did of the Laurel Highlands.
Hey!
So say hi.
Bob Perry, from Lynchburg, Virginia, originally from Washington, PA, and my brother-in-law Kenny is gonna be pretty pissed that he didn't get to see you, meet you, so.
So you doing the whole thing?
Doing the whole thing.
Doing the whole thing. When are you getting finished?
Saturday?
Saturday.
Yeah, Saturday, finishing up in Ohio.
Awesome.
Well, it's been beautiful so far.
Yeah.
Love it. Love this trail.
How's the water situation down that way?
Oh,
I heard 271's dry, I heard.
Yeah, going from 30 to 271, it's pretty dry.
Okay.
It was pretty rough. Luckily there was a water cache halfway in between for us.
Yeah, the Boy Scouts I heard from there was a guy that stayed with me at the turnpike yesterday. He told me about it. But
yeah. From here to the road the streams are flowing.
Awesome.
Cool.
That's what I like to hear.
Yeah.
Well hey man.
Hey.
It's great meeting you.
Great meeting you.
Take it easy and good luck on your hike, dude.
Yeah, you too.
We just passed mile marker 45. So we got 25 miles till we finish this thing. This is beautiful. These flowers over here, I believe, are called mountain laurel. And the Laurel Highlands hiking trail gets its name from these flowers. I just put two and two together just now. I've been seeing this since the start on Monday in Ohio Pile. Now I know what to look for and why this is named, because there is a ton of these flowers spread across the trail. You could probably see them in most of the shots I did for the video. And they smell really, really nice too. Just walking through this area, you can actually smell the flower.
Okay, I believe this is Machine Run. So here's the deal.
I know, based on the map, that this is pretty much the last reliable water source until you get to the shelter area that we're staying at tonight, which is like 9 miles away from now. Plus, the shelter pump at Route 71 is actually broken right now, so there's no water at the shelter area except a little stream, from what I'm hearing, that runs along part of that shelter area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill up as much water as I can, drink some water now, and then that'll be it till camp, unless I come across something else.
The infamous tic-tac-toe board. You have your X's and your O's. Looks like this game was a tie. So it's really cool that the trail maintenance people will do this for us.
It feels great seeing this stuff. So if you're a maintenance worker on this trail, I want to say thank you very much. I mean, you've done an excellent job here. Good place for a bear right there. What do you think?
Well, that one's empty. That one's empty. And that one's empty. Okay, well, they had a water cache here. At least. Oh well.
That's why I filled up at machine run. I knew it was going to be pretty dry from here to the shelter. Okay, well, I just hit mile 55. Starting to get a little tired. Really want to get off my feet at this point. But we're almost there at least. Going to mile 56 and a half. And then from there, it's about a mile down to the shelter area. So, pretty soon, I'll be able to relax. Scenery hasn't changed much. It's just been ferns and tall grass, so I didn't bother filming all that much. But I am looking forward to getting to the shelter area and relaxing.
Oh, that's a tight squeeze.
Well, I've just arrived at Route 271 shelter area. It was about a mile walk from the Laurel Highlands Trail down here. But looks like a nice place. Found a spot over here with a fire ring, and we are right next to a small creek. Plenty enough to get water out of, though.
Well, that almost wraps up another, I think, very, very successful Laurel Highlands thru-hike. Can you guys guess what mountain house meal I have saved for last? I'll give you just 1 second. Time's up. It is... No, it's not lasagna, but there's beef stroganoff in here. Oh, it's gonna be so, so delicious. Oh, I love this meal. This has gotta be their best meal. But yeah, this is my celebration dinner again. Just like the last through hike. So we're supposed to get thunderstorms around 3 o'clock in the morning tonight. And I'm in a pretty protected area, it looks like and feels like. But the wind can still cut through here. So I am just wrapping up Armada. I think I have like 2 or 3 chapters left, so I'll finish that before bed. And then I actually have a movie on my phone that I'm gonna watch. I know, roughing it, right? But I'm going to eat my delicious beef stroganoff with noodles. And then we'll have to see. We might have a fire, we might not. Just depends. Oh. So guys, with that, I want to thank you so much for joining me on this adventure of the Laurel Highlands. And we got one more day. So I will see you in the morning.
Good night, guys.
Well, I guess the weathermen were finally right for once, but I was kind of hoping this time they'd be wrong. Good morning, everybody. It is day 4, and today I'm gonna hike out of here. The storm started about 4 o'clock, I'd say. Some thunder, some lightning, not a big deal. I did get the chance to test the doors out because the wind was actually blowing some of the rain onto my underquilt last night. So I deployed the doors, didn't get wet. Really thankful to have them. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pack what I can up now, move over to a shelter and have some breakfast, and then we'll deploy from there, I guess. Alright guys, last day, 14 miles, let's hit it.
Okay, north, that's where we want to go. Just got back on the Laurel Highlands Hiking Trail. It's about a mile from the shelter area back up here, uphill. But hey, the rain's holding out, it's a little misty, a little foggy today. Looks pretty cool. And I think we have about 13 miles to do today. It's about 7:10, I'd say. So right on schedule. I actually woke up, ate breakfast, packed, and got on the trail in under an hour. So I think that's record time for me. That's pretty good. That's eating breakfast as well. Looks like we're gonna cross Route 271. So hey, let's get to it. So far, it was an amazing adventure. And yeah, the sky looks like it's starting to turn blue now. That's great news, man. Yeah, well, there's no way around it. I'm gonna get my pants soaked through here, but oh well. Going from a tarp without doors to a tarp with doors, just having that option for you available is, man, it's hard to explain the confidence level you get. You don't have to worry about, you know, is my underquilt getting wet or your hammock getting wet. You can have that just peace of mind. You just sleep better, I guess. I don't know.
Well, look at that sky. I don't know if it's coming across on camera, but it looks pretty cool. It's like a layer of real low clouds right at the top of this mountain. Very nice. Sun's out. It's still a little gray, but I can see blue peeking out over there and over here. So hopefully that comes in to me and we can wrap this adventure up. I just passed mile marker 60, so 10 more miles now. My shoes are pretty wet right now just from the rain last night. You know, the mesh running up across the grass and the weeds and stuff up here. So about the halfway point, I will switch into a dry pair of socks to kind of help my feet from blistering.
Okay, I remember this all too well. This gravel road is a logging road, and we are going down here for about a mile on this road. They do have the yellow blazes along here. You just have to look for them. They're way off in the distance. You can kind of see that one way over there. I remember not being sure that I was on the right path on my last thru hike, so definitely remember it now though.
More miles.
I'm halfway done with today's mileage. Just put on a dry pair of socks. The sun's out and it's an absolutely beautiful day.
You can actually hear the electric going through here. It's pretty wild. Okay, this is Route 51 shelter area down there. If you watched my last thru-hike of this place, that's where we stayed on our first night. But we are going to keep heading north, and we
should be around mile marker 65. So after this hill, it's all a loss of elevation and we just keep going downhill. And actually, there's mile marker 65 right there. So making some good time today. I'll probably be out around noon. I think it's about 10 o'clock right now.
All right, guys, just about 3.5 miles left. I think that is Johnstown over there. I could be mistaken. You can't see it right now, but this is the Conemaugh Gorge and the Conemaugh River runs right through it.
From this point on, it's basically, we're just going downhill. We're losing a ton of elevation right now. And at the bottom will be the parking lot. So ladies and gentlemen, I've begun my descent.
What a view. Oh yeah. Awesome. Clouds are rolling in though. Oh, there's rhododendrons all around me, completely encircling. That's pretty cool. It's really dark here. Video is actually brighter than what I'm seeing. Ooh, one more mile to go.
Pretty happy with the trip. I had a chance to clear my head a little bit out here. Laurel Highlands is great for that. Well guys, I'm pretty much out. I can see the mile marker right here. But that was an awesome trip. I'm so happy that I was able to do it in 4 days this time. I really wanted to push myself to do that and I finally did it and met my challenge. So I wanted to say, because I know I'm gonna get asked this, do I prefer hiking from mile 0 to 70 or 70 to 0? I'd say they're both a pretty good tie. However, just because the Ohio Pile area has so many views, I'd say start at 70 in Johnstown and hike to Ohio Pile. Anyway guys, I want to thank you so much for joining me on this adventure of the Laurel Highlands Hiking Trail. It was freaking awesome. 70 miles in 4 days. If you have any questions about the trail, please let me know. Just comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Also, if you have any questions about any of the gear you've seen in this video, you can also ask away. That feeling never gets old. I'll tell you what. Mile marker 70. Thanks for watching, guys. Find time and go on your own adventure. I'll see you on the trail. Thank you.
start their day. This is, you know, I'm just thinking about all the important things in my life right now, and I really want to know why. Out of all the animals in Winnie the Pooh, how come only Pooh and Eeyore are named? Well, this is a very muddy section. I mean, think about it. You got rabbit, piglet, owl, and kangaroo, basically. And then you have Eeyore and Pooh. What the heck? Weren't the other animals important enough in the storyline to give them names as well? Real names? I mean, I guess you got Christopher Robin, but he's creepy, so he doesn't count. And even Tigger. I mean, Tigger's tiger. That's crazy. And is it Winnie? Is Winnie Pooh's first name, or is Pooh Pooh's first name? I don't know what a Pooh is. Well, I know what a Pooh is, but... Oh, the things you think about when you're hiking alone with long mileage. Oh, well.